Yesterday we took a look at SHIB and predicted a breakout, but we just weren't ready for how big this one was. Today we're going to take another look and perform some technical analysis based on what has occurred over the past 24 hours on the Shiba Inu coin. And we're going to get into the nitty gritty detail of where we can expect to see the coin go next. Let's get into it. How's it going, guys? Ryan here, and welcome back to another crypto video. We're taking another look at SHIB as we had an absolutely insane breakout overnight. This is something we predicted in my last video, but it was even bigger than we expected. We're going to be performing some more technical analysis on the coin using various indicators such as moving averages, points of key resistance and support, as well as trends, in order to make some predictions on where we can expect to see SHIB go next. But before we get into all that good stuff, guys, please remember to leave a thumbs up if you do enjoy today's video. And if you want to see more of this sort of content, remember to turn on those bell notifications and hit subscribe. We cover crypto, stocks, investing and wealth management. Of course, I'd love to know, are you a Shiba Inu holder? Let me know down in the comments section below, and I'm sure if you are, you would be very, very excited about what we have just seen overnight. But without any further ado, let's jump into the computer and start today's analysis. Welcome into the SHIB chart, guys. If you're looking to buy SHIB or just want some free Bitcoin, there are a couple of links in the description of today's video. But let's take a look at what's happened over the past 24 hours. Oh my God, look at the size of this candle. It is absolutely insane. Just for a bit of perspective, we were sitting down here yesterday when I reviewed the crypto, and SHIB has absolutely blown through my targets, which I'll put back in place for us so we can see exactly where they were at. We predicted a breakout, but I don't think anyone expected it to be just this big. So let's put in place some of our key areas that we were, I suppose, looking at yesterday. So just chucking in our first one, it was here at about 970, and we were saying, you know, this is a key point for us. At that point in time, it was a key point of resistance. I'll just shuffle that one down slightly. There you can see it is a key point of resistance across the board over here, as well as in the past as well. As you can see, we smashed through it, absolutely annihilated it. Our next key point of resistance was sitting at 950. I'll plonk that one right about there. Close enough. You can see that's, I suppose, the little peaks that we were seeing back in the past over here. It was touching that point on a regular basis. And more recently, we saw these points touched over the past couple of months. But then our ultimate target, if we were able to break out, was that 1,000 mark. And that was a psychological number we really wanted to bust through if possible. And I expected it would take a few attempts in order to get there. But as you can see, how wrong was I? I predicted the breakout, but I didn't predict that we would smash through these key points of resistance within literally hours. And we went all the way up here to a value of 1520, which is 50% more than the target we had in place. That is absolutely crazy. We're now currently sitting at 1297, roughly, so still all the way up there. We've experienced a bit of pullback, as you'd expect to see, though, after a massive run. But let's just zoom out slightly to see exactly where we are in perspective of the rest of the chart. You can see as we zoom out, obviously we have these huge days over here. I'm just going to slowly remove those so we can zoom in slightly. As you can see, I'm putting things into context now. Okay, let's grab a new point of resistance. This high that we are seeing at roughly 1500, 1520, this sort of range, I'm going to plonk it right there. It's about right all the way across here. As you can see, that is our new point of resistance. You can see all the price action that has occurred at this point back in May of this year, and that is the point we have touched and then bounced off right now. So overall, looking really, really good from that perspective. I think we could potentially see another bit of a pump and a test of this point. Will we break through it? I don't know. We've had a massive, massive day and we need it to cool off a bit. You can see the volume was just absolutely insane. So it's going to cool off a bit likely. How long it will cool off for, I'm not sure. But where are our key points of support? Well, obviously we've got 1,000, but we are much higher than that. And you can see we got all the way down to roughly 1210 today. So if we, you know, zoom back out, is that a key point of support for us? And you'll see that, yes, it is. And as we take this line down here, you can see that this 1210 area has been tested in the past when we had our original dip, and obviously the day of the dip as well. Zooming out slightly, you can see that this was a point of support in the past as well. But let's zoom back in now and take a look at this. And I think realistically now, looking at this from a daily perspective is quite hard due to the fact that you can see obviously everything that's going on now. There's quite a bit. And I think as well, there's probably another key point here in the middle, but you know, there's only a few days worth of trading action on that, but I'm going to put a line in there just for perspective. So that's sitting right there where we had a few more days worth over on the left hand side here of price action, sitting basically at the point at which we were at the high today. So overall, looking relatively good from that perspective, but I want to take it down now to the hourly chart in order to work out exactly what's going on. And for those of you who have watched my videos before, you'll notice there is a pattern that has formed. And it's quite an obvious pattern. The pattern is a flag pattern. So we got our pole here and we have our flag pattern forming in this sort of a direction. This is actually perfect. A perfect flag we are seeing right now. As you can see, it's more of a pennant. That is the style of flag we're seeing, which is indicating we're having, you know, consolidation. And based on this, within the next hour or two, we are going to see a breakout. You can see we tested that top end at 1354 over here, but within the next couple of hours, 2 to 3 hours, we are going to likely see a big, big breakout occur. And it is most likely going to be in an upwards direction. I mean, we're trending upwards. That is the logic that we need to apply here. As you can see, zooming out, the volume was just absolutely crazy. We've not seen that sort of volume in a very long time. Even back when we had a little pump mid-September, nothing like what we saw in recent times. So overall, this pennant flag is looking like we're going to see another breakout occur. So looking very, very promising from that perspective. Let's bring in a few more indicators in order to help us determine exactly what is going on with this coin. Let's bring in, of course, our moving, MACD. I'll bring in the MACD first. I was going to bring in the moving averages, but you know what? I'm not going to do that. On the hourly, you can see that is crossed downwards now after a breakout. But if we go back to that daily chart, what you'll notice is everything is moving upwards, and it's moving upwards fast. Whilst yes, we're going to start to see a little bit of a dip potentially, the breakout that may occur on the hourly could result in this breaking upwards. If we do go back to that hourly chart though, what this is showing us is a downwards cross, but we are seeing that this blue line may be, you know, mellowing out and starting to come up and doing that sort of an action here. We're already in the red zone. Now, I think right now we're seeing the peak of the red point, and we're going to get this coming down and then going back into the green from that perspective. So I think we're looking quite good right here, which is very, very nice. One thing that won't be looking good is probably the relative strength index. And that's purely due to the fact that we've had so much of a price bump. Yes, we are on the hourly, actually, it's not looking too bad. We're sitting at an RSI of 61.69. But if we look at where we hit, it was 90.98. Very, very overbought. But as we know, cryptos don't really care about how long they're in the overbought, oversold space. But you can work out the direction it's going to go from that. If we take the daily, you can see we are definitely still in the overbought space. 83.01 was our peak. We're currently sitting at 78.68. So still well above that 70 mark and in between, you know, our band of 30 to 70 is where we ideally will sit. But when you see these massive volumes occur, it is not uncommon to see that we will stay in this sort of a region for an extended period if the buying momentum does continue. So overall, looking pretty interesting on this side of things. So let's just remove that one for now. Let's also just bring in our moving averages, as I mentioned previously. I'll bring in our 20-day moving average. And of course, I'll bring in as well our 50-day moving average, our medium term for this one right now. Make that one red. And what you can see is really what happened, as I mentioned in last video, was we had a golden cross occur. And for me, from a technical perspective, that is really what indicated to traders that, okay, this is about to go, along with all the other indicators which were showing, such as the MACD, that we were going to be on the move very, very soon. So overall, looking pretty good. If we go the hourly once again on that, you can see everything's still moving beautifully upwards at this point in time. Doesn't look like this shorter term moving average is really letting off at this point in time. So good stuff, really good stuff there, guys. But we've got to make a prediction. Where are we expecting to see SHIB go in the near future? Well, if we break upwards, which at this point in time, I think it is very, very feasible. How do we work out where we're going? Well, I like to use the size of the previous flagpole in order to determine that. So I'm going to grab that, put it here, and I'm going to put it right at the tip of our previous flag. We're going to now zoom out to the daily chart and work out exactly where does that peak. Well, as you can see, zooming in on here, it peaks at roughly 1951. So for me, that is our target at the moment. We've broken out. Now, yes, I think we're going to break out within the next few hours again. We need to get through these resistance points here, obviously sitting at 1400 and at 1520 odd. We need a break up and we need to smash to 1950. We could see the 20s again very soon, or the 2000s if you'd prefer. That would be ideal, but based on that flagpole methodology, that is where we are going within the next few days. Well, what can I say? It's been a crazy 24 hours for SHIB holders, and I'm sure many of you are feeling very, very excited. But my advice would be don't panic based on what is going on. Don't panic buy, don't panic sell. You want to watch for the indicators and what they do. You want to make sure the price action is reflecting your expectations. Don't just dump all your money into it because it looks like it's about to break out. Wait for the confirmation. Wait for the confirmation that we break out of that pennant in an upwards direction. That is your buy signal in this sort of a sense. But conversely, it is also possible that SHIB could break downwards purely due to the fact that we are now very overbought. And it was due to the large amount of volume that has pumped in. So that is obviously a scenario as well. But I think given the momentum and the positivity surrounding the crypto space, particularly over the last, you know, 24 to 48 hours, we are looking like we're in a very, very good position. But of course, let me know your thoughts on SHIB down in the comments section below. If you did enjoy this video, of course, remember to leave a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of these sort of analysis videos, remember to hit subscribe and turn on those bell notifications. We cover crypto, stocks, investing, and wealth management. But I'm going to leave it there for the day, guys. I hope you have an awesome day. I'll see you next time. Cheers.